You may have heard a math teacher or two say math is a language. If that is true, then algebraic rules and notation should be considered the grammar and punctuation of the language of math. Some students who struggle with math are confused by how to apply the rules and interpret the notation. In this video, we will focus on the notation and interpretation of exponents. This video will focus on the meaning of exponents that are natural numbers, also referred to as counting numbers, which are 1, 2, 3, things like that. Other types of exponents are interpreted differently and will be covered in other videos. Let's start by quickly reviewing some terminology. An exponent is written as a superscript on a number or algebraic expression, which is referred to as the base. There are a few ways to verbalize a power. This simple example can be read as 5 squared, 5 to the second, 5 raised to the second power, or 5 raised to the power of 2. In any case, the exponent should be interpreted as repeated multiplication. Whatever is defined as the base should be multiplied by itself however many times the exponent implies. For example, 5 squared equals 5 times 5. This can then easily be evaluated as 25. Let's look at some more examples. 7 cubed. This time the base is 7 and the exponent is 3. This can be read as 7 to the third or 7 cubed. Raising a base of 7 to the power of 3 means to multiply 7 by itself 3 times. 7 times itself 3 times equals 343. Let's try another one, but this one will look a little different. Negative 2 squared. It is important to point out that parentheses are being used with this example to define the base. Negative 2 is being raised to the second power. The interpretation is the same. Simply multiply negative 2 by itself twice. Multiplying two negative numbers using parentheses results in a positive value. But if we were to take the parentheses away and instead say negative 2 squared, then our answer would be negative 4. Why? Because the 2 is squared before the effects of the negative can take place. So we have 2 times 2 equals 4, and then the negative affects it. Let's try another one with negatives. Negative 5 cubed. This is equal to negative 5 times negative 5 times negative 5, which gives you negative 125. Powers of 10 are used frequently in math and science applications. Scientific notation uses powers of 10 to express very large or small values in an efficient and organized manner, but we'll dive into that topic in another video. Exponents are also used to raise algebraic expressions to powers, but the meaning is the same. Multiply whatever the base is by itself, however many times that is indicated by the exponent. Here are a few examples. X cubed is equal to x times x times x. As you can see, the notation x cubed is a more efficient way to write the expanded version of x times x times x. 2x cubed is equal to 2 times x times x times x. Notice that the base here is x. Adding parentheses to an expression changes the meaning. If you put in parentheses, 2x cubed means 2x times 2x times 2x, which is equal to 2 times 2 times 2 times x times x times x. Which, when you simplify that, gives you 8x cubed. Let's try one more example before we go. X plus 2 squared. Once again, the parentheses here are used to define the base to be x plus 2. The exponent of 2 instructs you to multiply this base by itself twice. So it equals x plus 2 times x plus 2. Multiplying these two binomial expressions results in the quadratic expression x squared plus 4x plus 4. So, as long as you can identify the base, the multiplication of that base by itself becomes pretty straightforward. As mentioned, the interpretation of notation in math is half the battle. Practicing the basics is key in order to gain confidence for more complicated math content. Thanks for watching and happy studying.